Updated, 2:42 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, February 4, 2020.
Top line, Monday night's Iowa caucuses dragged on into the early hours of Tuesday with no clear Democratic winner declared, and the New York Times reported that a brand new, untested mobile app designed in just 2 months was at least partially to blame for the holdup in results.
What to watch for, the IDP expects to formally announce results sometime Tuesday, although it could take longer. Price said, our ultimate goal is to ensure that the integrity and accuracy of the process continues to be upheld. NBC reported. The Nevada Democratic Party issued a statement Tuesday afternoon saying they will not use the app in their caucus later this month, after multiple outlets reported that the party would indeed use the app.
Big number, $63,000. That's how much the IDP paid Shadow to develop the app, according to the Wall Street Journal. Other Democratic candidates have also used Shadow for campaign work. According to Federal Election Commission filings, Buttigieg paid Shadow $42,500 for software rights and subscriptions. Both Joe Biden and former contender Kirsten Gillibrand paid Shadow for campaign work, $1,225 and $37,400, respectively.
Reminder, this is the second snafu for the Iowa caucus. Saturday night's Des Moines Register, CNN poll results were withheld after Buttigieg's campaign complained his name was left off a telephone survey earlier in the week. And the Washington Post said that the 2016 IDP caucus results between Hillary Clinton and Sanders were not announced for hours, with Clinton finally emerging the victor with a half of a percentage point in her favor.
Key background, Shadow, a startup founded by former Hillary Clinton campaign staffers Gerard Niemeyer and Krista Davis, is attached to progressive nonprofit Acronym, an investor. Acronym was founded by former Barack Obama campaign staffer and journalist Tara McGowan. The IDP said last month it wanted to use the app, according to the WSJ, because it would be a quicker way to tabulate the caucus results from the state's nearly 1,700 precincts.
News peg, for the first time, the Democratic Party will release three different results tallied during each stage of Iowa's unusual caucusing process. The first alignment result will show caucus goers' preferences in the first round of voting. This is equivalent to the popular vote in the state. The final alignment is taken after candidates who don't get at least 15% of the vote are eliminated and voters who supported those candidates shift their vote to viable contenders still in the running. After applying a formula to the final alignment results, a state delegate equivalent will be calculated, which is the number of delegates each candidate will get at Iowa's statewide convention. Whoever gets the highest state delegate equivalent wins Iowa, and that number is proportionally translated into how many of the state's 41 national delegates each candidate gets.